Welcome to Forecasting, Heroes of the Storm commentary for professional and amateur level games casted by myself, Sinvicta. Let's head into the storm. Hello everybody, welcome to game number two of Forecasting Live, number nine, coming at you live here on twitch.tv/Sinvicta, also on the VODs at youtube.com/Sinvicta316. You see the channels up in the top portion of my fancy schmancy overlay. I have adjusted the graphics settings from game one. The graphics settings got automatically set to ultra, so I'm hoping that the I don't know if the YouTube audience will notice any graphical lag, but I definitely saw some a little bit here on my end. So hopefully that should be cut down by a substantial amount for game number two. It was Team Blue winning game number one. Can they close out the series, or will Team Red be able to force an extended series? We'll have to wait and find out. Here we are on the Cursed Hollow, spawning for Team Blue. Introducing the players right now. Tyrone gonna be played by Funny Man. Chex Mixer gonna be playing as the other person in the lane is going to be Sonya. Mid lane is going to be played by Bloodbat273, playing as mid lane Sylvanas. Last but not least, in the bottom lane for Team Blue, Esprit playing as Jaina, and Starshimmer playing as good old Abathur. Spawning for Team Red, Possum going to be playing as Zagara in the mid lane. It's going to be Latrudos on Arthas, as well as Atlas playing as Nazebro. Up in the top lane, it's going to be Leviathan playing as Vala, joined by Murloc Queen, who is playing as Lili. So it was, again, game number one taken by Team Blue. Team Red had a golden opportunity to come back in that game. Murloc Queen's got to be careful. Murloc Queen's got to be careful. Lili's good, but she's not invincible. Nice job there. Down goes Lili. First blood goes to Abathur of all heroes. Nice awareness there by Star Shimmer to see that Lili was very, very hurt. Using Symbiote on Tyrone to take out Lili. Solo lane matchup's gonna be Zagara versus Jaina. Technically, Abathur's down there with her, but we all know that Abathur doesn't necessarily count for any lane. He just counts for all lanes. Again, a good Abathur player will be pretty much bouncing everywhere. Pretty much everywhere, and Abathur... Toronto taking a lot of damage there, coming in from Murloc Queen as well as Leviathan. Vala's got to be careful. She is not the most sturdiest of heroes. Neither is Lili, to be quite honest. Of course, Lili's best strength is her speed, able to get out of sticky situations. And again, it was Team Blue who ended up taking game one. Team Red had a chance to get back in there, but unfortunately, it was just not enough. As soon as the heroics came down from Team Blue, it was all Team Blue all day, every day. Easily pushing over the Dragonshire in game one in about 17 and a half minutes. So we'll have to wait and find out if game two is going to be any different. Again, I do know that both teams do tend to swap around. You may see people who are playing for Team Red one day and then Team Blue for the next. We don't keep the same teams here. We just do it in a fun make-believe tournament matchup to see which team wins. Let's put it that way. It makes it for a more engaging viewing experience, in my opinion. Twitch chat currently voting to see who will take game number two. A lot of votes going for Team Red right now. I don't know if that's wishful thinking or if that's actually how they feel about the team comp. I'll say for a team fight, it definitely goes to Team Red. They've got the better of the two team fights, in my opinion. With the AoE damage coming in, assuming that Mazeba goes for Ravenous Spirit, they've got the crowd control of Arthas as well as Zagara throwing out the Maul. That could be very, very deadly. You can never count out Abathur, especially with Sylvanas now. Dropping out double Withering Fire is absolutely hilarious. And the first tribute spawn is going to happen here, right around the 2:47 mark. Team Red now getting in position, and Arthas has got to be careful. Sylvanas knows all about Arthas. Jaina now going in as well, trying to interfere with Zagara. Arthas taking a lot of damage. Here comes Sonya coming in from the top lane. Power play in favor of Team Blue, but Sonya's going to get taken out. It's back to 4v4. Murloc Queen doing a nice job keeping everyone alive. 4v4 now. Where is Abathur? I don't know where Abathur is currently at right now, but it looks like they're just going to give up the first tribute in favor of trying to stay alive. And there's another snipe there by Lili, and they actually get another kill. It's a 3-for-none scam in favor of Team Red. Nice job. Actually, 3-for-1 technically, because Arthas did go down, I believe. Did Arthas die? I think he did. Yeah, he died. Like I said, I don't even remember what happened 10 minutes ago, let alone 5 seconds ago. It's kind of crazy. Like, there's so many things to pay attention to in the early goings of every Heroes of Storm game that you just don't really notice a whole lot of stuff. So one level lead now led by Team Red. And again, the first tribute, not that big of a deal, but here is the biggest of deals, the second tribute. Quite possibly the most important tribute of the game, because it basically determines if the team who got the first tribute is going to get the earliest possible curse. And if you have even levels here with your team fight, it could go well. I don't know what Sylvanas is doing. What is Sylvanas doing? Don't go AFK while you're playing a game of Heroes of the Storm. Almost cost Sonya her life here. Again, Latrudo's being pressured by everybody from Team Blue. And Sylvanas forced to back out. Looks like he was able to come back, but no, Vala's gonna be taking him out anyway, so there's that. There's you see the Lunar Flare stunning Arthas, but there's not gonna arrive in time to stop the cap on the tribute. And that's gonna be two straight tribute caps here by Team Red. Not sure what Sylvanas was doing at the beginning there. I'm going to assume that he probably just had a sneeze, that's all I can think of. Inopportune moment to sneeze for sure. You do see Abathur there using the symbiote, going after Lili, attaching himself to the night camp, but man, oh man, that was a little bit of a blunder there by Team Blue. They had a good opportunity. Team Red was a little bit injured, moving into position to take the second tribute, and then they ended up not doing it. Good creep spread here by Possum, laying the creep tumors everywhere, giving Zagara not only increased movement speed, but also health regeneration. And on top of all that, she's maintaining a good amount of vision on her portion of the bottom half of the map there. Bloodback now going after the giant camp. This is what makes Sylvanas a specialist. She can easily take out jungle camps solo. Easily, easily. That's why she's so versatile here. Siege Jam is going to be led by Sonya for Team Blue. Team Red going to be led by Zagara. Both of them pretty much even on siege damage. Zagara versus Sonya, the siege damage champion so far in Game 2 of Forecasting Live number 9. It looks like Twitch chat voting for Team Red to take the victory here in Game 2. Let's find out if they are able to do that. Here comes a bush gank right now on top of Vala. Vala barely able to vault out of the way here. And where's Zagara? Zagara is not going to go after the third tribute. And that might be a little bit of a goof there by Team Red. We'll have to find out. Chex Mixer is able to escape. Down goes Arthas. Bloodbank going for more. Unfortunately, he ran right after Vala. Not what he wanted. Here comes Possum on Zagara. Finally reinforcing his team. Down goes Sonya. Down goes Jaina. And down goes Team Blue's only hope of stopping the first cap here on the cycle of the Dravenlord curse in Game 2. So Team Red getting three straight tributes. And that is not a good start for Team Blue. And again, this is the reason why I say the second tribute is probably the most important of the entire game. It prevents three straight tribute caps like this and allows your team to catch up, especially if your team was the team that did not get the first tribute cap. You get to get caught up in XP across all board, and you possibly set yourself up for a good kill. But here we go. The heroics have been picked. You did see Nazebo there now taking Ravenous Spirit. Nidus Worm actually taken by Zagara. Army of the Dead. Jug of 1,000 Cups. And we'll have to wait and see what Sonya or what Sylvanas is going to take for her heroic. I'm expecting it's going to be Wailing Arrow, but you just never know. Arthas was taken out there by, in the mid lane by Bloodbat and Sonya. Counterkill was happened there by Nazebo. So again, the power play is going to go to no one. 4 versus 4. Reign of Vengeance. I don't know why I thought that was Sylvanas. Reign of Vengeance taken by Leviathan. I was looking at this line thinking it was Sylvanas. Nazebo barely able to escape there. So not a bad, I would say it wasn't a really bad Ravenlord cycle there for Team Blue. They did lose the top fort. But if that's all that they lose after abysmally failing getting any of the tributes for the first three of the game, honestly, that's not a bad deal at all. Here we go, Team Blue now finally getting their heroics, and you see everyone now picking their heroic abilities. There is Wailing Arrow, which is exactly what I was expecting. It looks like the Abathur is going to go for Ultimate Evolution instead of the Monstrosity, but he's going to get taken out by Possum there. Able to deduce where Abathur was thanks to the Locust. Wailing Arrow going after Arthas, not really the best opportunity there, but here comes the Starfall. Jug of 1,000 Cups also healing everybody, and pretty much no one's taking damage thanks to Lili's ultimate. Tyrone forced it back out of there, and the power play in the mid lane right now, 3 versus 2, and there's a nice zombie wall landed by Atlas. Sonya barely able to escape thanks to Whirlwind. Zagara was taken out by Jaina of all people down here in the bottom lane. Apologies for missing that. Again, so much to watch here in Game 2 of Forecasting Live number 9 and number 9. Mambo Number 9. You can see the standard APM here. Spammed by Tyrone. Now, overall XP contribution led here by Lili. 12,000 XP. As she was part of that top fort kill. Remember, if you do get a fort kill, that's worth 400 XP for your entire team. Kill totals look like this. 9-5 right now in favor of Team Red. So far, Twitch chat's predictions coming up. They're coming up everything Millhouse right now. Blue, I don't know what that was. Funny man may have saw something on his keyboard. That's the only thing I think of. Here goes Rain of Vengeance now. Leviathan trying to get a cheap, easy kill here, but she's forced to back away. Is Vala. They are able to see the Nidus Swarm here dropped by Zagara. And Team Red looking like gonna make a play. Down goes Sylvanas. Sylvanas was taken out by the roaches because she was stunned by the boss mob. Down goes Sonya as well. Oh, disaster for Team Blue. That is why you never even attempt to take the boss mob if all of five members of your enemy team are up and active. You're setting yourself up for fail. You have to have at least one person down on the enemy team before it's safe to go after the boss mob. And now the problem is going to be compounded by the fact that Team Red's going to have excellent position to get the fourth tribute overall. And before this tribute spawns, I think Team Red might even go up by two levels, which means that Team Blue just cannot contest this. Lili was killed there by Tyrone and Jaina, but the fourth tribute has been capped. Sonya going back to the top side here just to clear the wave. And Team Blue in a lot of trouble, I've got to say. Again, if you are watching this live, you can join in on the action, get a chance to join in on the action. Just do a /join Sinvicta in the North American group chat. Here's the storm now. Tyrande's got to be careful, even though she's joined by Abathur. It doesn't necessarily guarantee safety. Although you saw how much damage Abathur was able to throw on top of Vala, but look at that. Rain of Vengeance able to take down Tyrone. Sonya getting a counter kill there, but here comes the big brawl. 2v2 tag team. Arthas and Nazebo taking on Chex Mixer, as well as Star Shimmer. Actually, that was Abathur. It's double Sonya. They were able to completely chew through Arthas. So the tag team duo of Sonya squared. Here comes the Ravenous Spirit coming out from Nazebo, doing a little bit of damage there to Sylvanas, but that is about it. Unfortunately, that Spirit not traveling fast enough to maintain that DPS. So power play actually favors Team Blue here. This could be what they needed to turn this game around, because right now it's been all Team Red all day, every day here on the Curse of the Raven Lord, also known as the Cursed Hollow. Here we go, Team Blue does have the power play, but they've got to be careful now. Chex Mixer going after the Zebo. If he gets hit by a zombie wall, it could be up, but there's the Whirlwind taking out Zagara. Team Blue trying to make a play here for their first tribute cap of the game. Lili's ultimate already down. The Zebo does not have his ultimate either. Arthas now resurrecting. Down goes the Zebo, but Sonya's going to go down. They are able to take down Arthas as well. Team Blue turning it around. Down goes Vala. Can they finish off the ace? It's going to be a full team ace for Team Blue. Getting a 1-for-5 scam and the tribute. That's exactly what Team Blue needed to come back in this game. Wow. What a turnaround. And that was everything lined up perfectly for Team Blue as they had the power play going into that fifth tribute cap. They did not have the level difference, but Nazebo and Vala both did not have their ultimates for that engagement, and everything went Team Blue's way. That's exactly the type of perfect storm that they needed to come back into this game now. As Blue able to get their first tribute cap of the game, also going to be able to take down the boss mob. So Team Blue finally throwing another haymaker jab back at Team Red, which definitely rocked them, but they are far from over. Twitch chat now lamenting at the possibility of Team Red throwing the game here. I think it's a little too early to be calling it a throw. But Team Blue certainly in control now. Look at that. They were down at one point by two levels in this game. Now up by a level, if you can believe it. Here we go again. The next tribute spawning up here in the top lane. Sonya is first to arrive on the scene for Team Blue. They're going after Nazebo. Nazebo gets caught by Jaina. Jaina might be able to take him out. Nazebo's may get, I think he got saved by Lili. At the same time, Ball is going to get taken out. No, Nazebo was taken out by Jaina. It's going to be another 3-for-none scam in favor of Team Blue. Lili not going to be able to escape. See you later. Another 4-for-none scam. Zagara didn't even come up there to try to help because she's busy dealing with the boss mob. Team Blue was able to get the bottom fort as well. Oh, disaster again for Team Red. That one definitely sent them on the ropes. Team Red in a lot of trouble here. I thought Nazebo may have been saved by Lili. Turns out not going to be the case. Team Blue now with a huge power play. 1 versus 5. They are able to secure the boss mob on Team Blue, on Team Red's side of things, and they're going to be able to easily take this top fort. Team Red in a whole lot of trouble right now, as they're even going to be losing their night camp to Sonya and Vala. Funny Man may have overstayed his welcome here, but right now Team Red forced to back up to deal with the golem. Arthas did not get out in time here, so this is going to line up well for Team Blue. And really, it's going to come down to this next tribute. I believe this is tribute number 7, I want to say. I'm not really sure. I think it's tribute. Yeah, it has to be tribute number 7. And my, how the tables have been turned here is now Team Red down by 2 levels. Again, Arthas going to be going after Sylvanas, but this time Arthas is alive. He's just now taken out by Vala. Down goes Arthas. Sylvanas has been taken out as well. Team Red looking like they want to put up a fight here for this next tribute. Sonya going to be in a lot of trouble. She is taken out by Nazebo and Lili. Power play in favor of Team Red. They're going to get the 7th tribute, and oh my goodness. Team Blue throwing a little bit of an opportunity their way. Unfortunately for them, their Taranda was getting their night camp, and that is not really the most opportune moment to get the night camp. You want to wait till after you cap the tribute before you go for mercenary camps. Team Red also have a huge, huge creep wave pushing in the bottom lane, but they're currently still down by 2 levels overall. You can take a look at the siege damage there, led by Jaina. Look at the hero damage as well. 35,000 hero damage for Jaina, played by Esprick. Currently on the other side of the board is going to be Vala. No surprise there, leading far and away on the hero damage and the siege damage. With Nazebo coming in second there with the hero damage. But again, all eyes come down to this next tribute. Now Possum is going to get caught by Tyrone as well as Jaina. Possum not going to be able to escape the Kona Cold, able to blast Zagara away. Team Blue looking like they want to really send Red on the ropes now with this next tribute. And will Team Red be able to buy enough time for Zagara to get back? I don't know. Here comes the Ludafair. Going to land on Lili as well as Nazebo. Nazebo sprinting away. Arthas able to take down Jaina. Arthas going to try to fight the impossible mission. Team Blue going after Nazebo. Down goes Nazebo. Lili is dead. Arthas is dead. It's only Vala. Vala trying to kill Taranda. Not going to happen. And another disastrous opportunity for Team Red, as they are completely wiped out. It's going to be a full Team Ace, 1-for-5 scam. And now Team Red is in dire situation. They have definitely received almost lethal damage here. The curse falls upon you, heroes. And again, the latest patch, as Twitch chat is quick to point out, latest patch definitely improved Jaina's burst output for damage, which is what she kind of needed. Team Red in a really, really bad spot here. They may be able to get a fort cap here, which would take them to level 19, I do believe, but man, oh man. It is bad news right now for Team Red. You see the XP contribution right there, led by Sonya. For Team Blue, as they are looking like they want to push this next cap here of this tribute home. 15 seconds left on the Raven's Curse. Sonya and Jaina taking out their very own boss mob here. Sylvanas looked like he wanted to go for Team Red's boss mob, realized that that might be a bad idea. So Team Red now, they might actually smell blood in the water. This boss mob is not dead yet. Can anyone from Team Red get there in time to contest it? I don't think so. Vala tried to, but now he may have overextended. The boss mob has been engaged by Team Blue. Arthas coming in from the side, going after Jaina. Down goes Arthas, down goes Vala. Lili not in time to throw out the heals. Another disastrous play for Red, as they're forced to back out. They did lose Arthas. Abathur now going after Lili as well as Nazebo. And Nazebo and Lili might be in a little bit of trouble here. Nice zombie wall there, landed by Nazebo, able to save himself and Lili. But the problem is still going to be piling up for Team Red. They had such a huge control of this game early on, going into the mid game. But again, it came down to one disastrous team fight for that fifth tribute, and it's been all Team Red, Team Blue, pretty much it for the rest of this game here. Red really back on the last, on their last legs here in this fight. Volinarth is down for another 10 seconds. You gotta be careful, Zagara. It's not the same Jaina. She can't kill you. She will kill you. Gotta be careful. Zagara almost taken out there by Jaina. That would have been devastating. That would have been absolutely devastating. Arthas comes up. He is saved there by Lili. Here comes the leap coming in from Sonya. Countered by the Reign of Vengeance. They are going to get a cleanup kill on Sylvanas. Team Red really struggling to find the handle here in this game. Blue again taking control of all of Team Red's mercenaries in their own jungle. Nice job with the Lunar Flare. They're landing on not only Nazebo but Arthas as well. So power play favors Team Red. They've got to make a good play here. They are able to catch Chex Mixer off guard. Down goes Sonya. That might be what Team Red needs. The next tribute is now spawned up here in the top. This is exactly where Red needed. They've got a power play. 5v3. Arthas going after Tyrone. Tyrande trying to get away. Here comes Esper coming in from Jaina. And Arthas is going to get taken out. Tyrande taking a ton of damage from Vala. Down goes Tyrande and the Z-Bolt. Bolting away from Jaina. Big power play in favor of Team Red. They've got to get this tribute. Zagara already on the scene. Ravnus Spirit doing so much damage. Jaina's going to get taken out. Abner going to get taken out as well. And Team Red able to get a counter Raven Curse. That was the third tribute that they needed. So Team Red not out of it yet. Trying to make it come back. They've got a big push now going up in the top lane. And remember, the Curse of the Raven Lord drops all creep down to one outside of Mercenary. And that Grave Golem will be going down here momentarily. So this is a big turning point for Team Red. They've got a good opportunity to come back in this game now. Sylvanas taking her very own Merc Camp over here on the Siege Giants. But look at this push that this Curse has created in the top lane. And again, even Sonya gonna have a difficult time clearing all that without saving, without losing at least the gate here. So here we go again. Team Red now taking a golden opportunity, turning it into a Raven Lord's Curse, able to take out the top fort and the middle fort as well. Bottom fort's already gone. Here comes a nice Lunar Flare landed on top of the Zeebo. They can actually fight this now. Lili's got the Jug of 1,000 Cups, healing everybody. They can turn this around. Tyrande might be overextending. Here comes Arthas coming in from the top lane. Tyrande is going to get shrunk right there by Lili, but a nice Lunar Flare taking out Lili. Down goes Lili. Down goes Zagara. Arthas not going to be able to escape, and oh, what a turnaround for Team Blue. Nazebo tried to stop the Sonyas with the zombie wall. They just break right through it, and that might just be it. I don't know how it happened, but Team Red somehow threw away a golden opportunity. Team Blue looking like they want to end it. It's only Vala versus the entire team of Team Blue. That really could have turned around, but unfortunately Team Red stumbling as the core now going down to 86%. They were able to get Sonya. Vala's got to buy time here for the rest of her team to get up. Still about an average of 25 seconds before everyone gets back up here. And again, take a look at the siege damage by Sonya and Jaina. And even Sylvanas as well. Can Vala hold out here? It's all up to the Leviathan. Core sitting at 48%, falling rapidly. I don't think so. And that is going to be game number two. What a come from behind victory by Team Blue. Final total, 32-20. Team Blue taking game number two. And we'll have to wait and see if Team Red can force an extended series. Man,